Hello, Stampers! Jackie Bolhuis from Klompen Stampers. I have some fun projects to share with you today. We are focusing on using designer series paper, or DSP as you hear it called. And you guys, if you follow me, you know I love making quick and easy cards where the designer series paper is the focus. And I have a great, I guess, format. Some people even call it a one sheet wonder, but it's using a 6x6 piece of designer series paper to make two different cards. We're going to use all but a little teeny tiny bit of scrap from it. Now, I have 10 different cards I'm going to share with you. So we're going to make two, and then I'm going to show you 8 other ones. Now remember, this idea, because it really focuses on designer series paper, you can use with any paper for quick and easy cards. Plus, I have some fun new products to share with you today. So it's going to be a fun video. I've got lots of tips. We're going to share some tips about putting labels on your stamps and all kinds of stuff. So you're just going to have to watch all the way to the end so you don't miss anything. So without further ado, let's go ahead, flip this camera down, and let's get to today's 10 projects that I have for you. You know, now that we have this brand new spring summer mini catalog, I'm kind of overwhelmed with all the fun products in here. Now, what I want to share with you today, we're going to kind of focus on two different things, but I want to make sure you don't miss them in the catalog. Page 20, if you have this mini catalog. Now, if you don't have one of these and you don't have a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator and you're looking to purchase Stampin' Up! Products, I would love to be your demonstrator. Hop on over to my website and you can request a catalog and I'd be happy to send it to you. Now, what I want to share with you is this greeting set. And when you look through here, some people get a little confused because we've got all this gray and it's kind of a mess. What they're really doing is showing what dyes work the best with what greetings. And this is a bundle with greetings. And I am a sucker when it comes to good greetings, big greetings, especially ones, you know, that are nice and big that you really can just plop it on with some designer series paper and you're off and running. So it's called So Sentimental. But what I love is the stitched, and I got to double check here, Stitch So Sweetly dies. These, they bundle together or you can buy them separately. I mean, this obviously doesn't need these words and these words you can use without these, but they just, sizing, they fit so good. So we're going to make, like I said, two cards plus 8 other ones to share with you. Now, the paper I'm going to share with you, you might have missed. It is called Best Dressed. Now, when you flip through it, at first you think this is like super girly. Well, flowers are girly too, but that's all about the shoes and the purses and lipstick and all of that stuff. Well, if you're not into that, which I'm not so sure I am, I'm sure I'll do some cards in a while with that. But this pack of 6x6 paper is super cool because, well, one side has all the lipstick and perfumes and shoes and so forth, but the other side is all these gorgeous florals. There's a couple stripes in here. I think there's one, where'd it go? Oh, kind of a polka dotty one, but otherwise has nothing to do with the shoes and the lipstick and all of that. So great papers to use this side of it. And then there's all of that. So these are the papers we're using. And what I did is I just pulled out a bunch of the coordinating cardstock. If you've noticed in the catalog, I love now that they show really nice and big and bold all the different colors. So I know all of these colors are gonna work really well with those papers. So that's the colors of cardstock we're gonna use. Now, like I promised you, we are gonna go and start with just a 6x6 piece. And I'm gonna show you how to cut this to make two cards with hardly any scrap whatsoever. So since it's 6x6, we are gonna start by cutting a strip off that's 4 inches. And then this piece that's now 4 inches wide, I'm gonna cut it down to 5 1/4. So this is 4 by 5 1/4, which is the perfect size for layering onto a piece of cardstock. So we have pretty peacock here, and we're gonna go ahead, that's gonna layer on that one. And then this extra piece, which is 2 inches wide, we're gonna start by cutting a 1/2 inch off of it. Let's see, so we can, I'm just lining up on this side here. So then we have a piece here that's 1 1/2 wide, and we're gonna cut this down to 5 1/2. Now I told you we have a little bit of scrap. So this is a scrap, but we're gonna actually use both of these pieces. So this one's 4 by 1/2 inch. So let's get that scrap out of there. And then this one's 1/2 inch, and we're gonna actually trim this down
to 5 1/4. And you'll see why here as we put these cards together. So this is the only scrap we're gonna have out of the 6x6 piece of designer series paper after we've made our two cards. So let's set that aside. Let's move the cutter. Now, before we start assembling, we're gonna go ahead and we're going to stamp our greetings. Now, the one thing I don't often talk about, and if you follow me, you'll notice that quite often I don't put the labels on my my stamps. And I think that's just really actually a bad habit of mine from years ago. Well, not even years ago, like just a year ago, the labels did not stick very well, or they stuck on here, but they didn't stick to the blocks very good. So I never put them on. And so I'm so in the habit of not putting them on that, you know, I never really think to put them on. But I know a lot of you like them. And since they switch the labels and they're super sticky, if I kind of take the time to do it, I suppose I'll do it more often. But I want to show you how to put them on. We'll do one of these stamps here, the thank you one. So you're going to leave it right on there, peel off the backing, and then take the stamp. And these are super sticky. There is no forgiveness. So you cannot put it down and go, oops, it's wrong, and pick it up. It's not going to move. So I take my stamp and I'm gonna just line up this edge right here, right along the edge of that sticker. I can see it through there, kind of line up on the top and the bottom there and just press it right down in there. And then you can go ahead and pick it up. And now we have the label on that stamp. So that's how you stick those on there. And now the good thing is, if you're one that likes labels, these are not going anywhere. But I do caution you, when you're done using them, peel them off. Don't leave them sit like for days or hours and hours, because the longer they sit, sometimes they're a little hard to get off. And I've even had to go ahead and take like my piercing tool, if it's stuck down too good, and kind of get underneath an edge there and pick it up. So little tips on that. Now let's go ahead and stamp our labels. We are gonna use Blackberry Bliss because it is one of the colors in this. And let me grab some white scrap paper. I always think I have everything ready until I start stamping, and then I'm missing something. So on our scrap here, we're gonna go ahead and we'll stamp the I can't thank you enough. And let's just flip it over to this side. As long as we're doing this, we're gonna do both of them at one time. So wishing you much happiness. Now this is where these labels fit these so nice. So this big one fits perfectly right on there. And then this size fits perfectly right there. So I'm gonna go and run this through my Big Shot and I will be right back. There we go. So let's go ahead, stick these back on here. We can set that aside. And now all we have to do is go ahead and assemble our cards. And you'll see, this is kind of a layout idea, I guess. You could use this again with any papers. So we're gonna go ahead and put that 4 by 5 1/4 on the front of the Pretty Peacock card. And then I've got a mint macaron here one. Remember our little strip that was 1 1/2 by 5 1/4. Now again, don't worry about all of these measurements. I'm gonna go ahead and on the blog post, I will have a list of all the products I'm using along with the card recipes. So I'll even make a little diagram with you to show you how to cut a 6x6 designer series paper to make two cards like this. So we've gone ahead and we've stuck it on a 1 3/4 by 5 1/2 piece of Pretty Peacock. And we're gonna go ahead and stick that one right there like so. Then let's go ahead, grab these trusty dimensionals. I had a sticky note on the back of that. That's kind of funny, didn't even notice that. So we're gonna go ahead and put dimensionals. Kind of threw me for a loop there. You know what, we're gonna put one more. I like to use lots of these. I wanna make sure that when this goes through the mail that it doesn't get smushed down. So, you know, something this size, I put at least 5 or 6 dimensionals on there. Oh, come on. So there's that. And then we're gonna go ahead, let's see, a little fuzzy there, and we'll stick that right about there. And then on this other one, we're gonna turn it this way. And then I have just a 1/2 inch strip of the mint macaron. You could use a piece of ribbon here too if you wanted to, but a lot of times I'll just use a scrap of cardstock to add some coordinating colors on there. And then let's get our dimensionals. You guys find these dimensional pieces like everywhere in your house? I swear they stick to my shoes when I leave my stamp room, and they are, you never know where you're gonna find them. And then we're gonna go ahead and stick that right on that strip. So see, we got dimensionals everywhere. There are the two cards. Now we have to make sure we always do the insides. And whenever I use colored cardstock, I like to put a piece of white on the inside. And this is where we're gonna use these two other little pieces. So we're gonna go ahead and adhere these onto the white. So this one is 4 by 1/2 inch. So that's gonna go like so. And then this one will go on here like that. I don't really have words for the inside of these. You can decide, we can have that one go in there or there. And then this one could go that way or that. I think I like it that way. So then we can just stick this on here. Now, with this package of designer series paper, since there are 48 sheets and I made two cards out of it, if you use this card idea, you could really make 96 cards out of one package of designer series paper. The other thing I like to do, and I did not do it on any of these or the other 8 samples I have to share with you, but you could use some of that paper to do the envelopes as well. I like to do the envelope flap just to add another little extra prettiness to it. So there are our two cards out of one 6x6 sheet of designer series paper. But see how easy it is with those words to just use those frames, cut them out, and there we go. Now let me grab the other 8 that I want to share with you. So all of these are made basically the same way. There you go, you can see these two. Now the only difference here is I turned it this way, or yeah. So your little strip here is short instead of long. But same idea, there's the insides on these. And I did on quite a few of these, on the ones where you have a lot of the cardstock showing on the front, I used the Subtles embossing folder. It just adds a little nice texture on there to dress that up a little bit. Now, if you wanted to, you could add some ribbon or some other embellishments, but you can see here's two other ones. Can you see the embossing on that one? But you can see where I just pulled the coordinated cards out of the designer series paper. Same thing, the insides all basically look the same. They just use that same designer series paper. I thought this was kind of fun. Depending on what color is your main color, you know, here we have lovely lipstick, where here we have pretty in pink, I believe it is. But look at this one is so much softer looking, sending healing hugs, where I think this one just has a lot more pop because there's a lot more of that lovely lipstick color on that one. So there's that set. And then one more purple posy. Love the purple posy color. Now I know we can't get the ink, but it's such a light color that I probably would never use the ink anyways, but I love the cardstock. So, and then pair it with that pretty peacock. Those colors just pop. And there's the inside. So there you have it. 8 cards, all using the same basic idea. Like I said, you could do this with any designer series paper, but it's a great way to get the most out of those 6x6 pieces. Now, if you have 12x12 designer series paper that you want to use this idea for, just cut it into a 6x6 piece and then go from there. So once again, I'll have everything over on the website. I'll have a cutting diagram for you that'll show you how to cut it, and then all the measurements for all the cardstock and the extra little pieces, along with the list of everything I use. So again, if you don't have a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator and you'd like to order Stampin' Up! Products, I would love to be your demonstrator. Hop on over to my website. You can place an order on my online store. And if you have any questions whatsoever, make sure you get a hold of me. I'd love to help people make quick and easy cards. I've been doing this silly thing called Stampin' for over 25 years now as a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator. And I love to teach and I love to help you. So don't ever hesitate to contact me with any of your stamping questions. So until I stamp with you again, have a stamp happy day.